Brevard. We're going to watch this thunderstorm again very carefully. I wanted to poke around on that thing and take a look at the winds. And you're looking at the velocity product. We don't, see any couplets of red and green there. So that's certainly some good news. But one of the things that I did want to do was show you what kind of wind we're talking about now with this thunderstorm as it's basically rapidly moving off towards the south and the east. We're talking about 40, 50, even 60-mile-an-hour winds with this storm right now over rural Osceola County. Let's widen out the perspective now and show you what else is going on here across central Florida. First alert Doppler radar shows one cluster of storms here, a second one over towards Sanford, although that one is showing signs of weakening now here, so that's certainly some good news. We have heights on this particular thunderstorm upwards of 45,000 feet. We're going to watch the tail end of this thunderstorm. It's trying to curl around. Jason's putting a fan on there. It's moving southeast at about 19, 20 miles an hour. So over towards Vieira here, probably right around 543 as it's kind of curling off towards the south and the east. Now, the other thing we like to monitor is what's going on upstairs with these storms. And if we can loop this, Jason, just kind of loop that up top there, you can kind of see what's going on. This thunderstorm is actually beginning to grow and intensify. And on that last image, you can see, hopefully, it's peaking right now at about 2.5-inch diameter hailstones aloft. There's a very good chance that could reach the ground, especially with that colder air still in play today with that trough of low pressure going by to the north. So that's one of the things we have to watch. And the other cool thing we like to use with this new technology is to kind of show what's going on with the thunderstorm. You can actually see this thing growing vertically. And sometimes when you see it tailing out, we call that an overshooting top. The upstairs winds today aren't doing that just yet, but if it were to continue to grow, that would certainly be the case there. We've got other showers and storms in the weakening mode from DeLand over towards Geneva. And the West Coast sea breeze trying to get going through Sumter County, but having a hard time. Rainfall totals thus far today, Mineola an inch, DeBary a quarter of an inch, and we're continuing to add on to that. Temperatures outside low 80s, showers and storms through about 8, 9 o'clock, and then things will begin to wind on down. Now, as we look ahead to the upcoming weekend forecast here for you, 88 degrees, don't rule out an isolated late day thunderstorm. Rain chances running at about 30%. Morning low is very comfortable, by the way. Saturday and Sunday running in the mid-60s. Still about a 30% chance, Jim and Martha, for a thunderstorm on Sunday. We're taking the mention of rain out. We're taking it out for Monday and Tuesday. But the big developing story after this weekend, look at the 90s. Four in a row. Here we go.